We want to integrate 2x from 1 to 3 using the Fundamental Theorem of Calculus, which means if f of x, our integrand, is continuous and big f of x is any antiderivative of f of x, meaning the derivative of big f of x is equal to small f of x on the closed interval, we can evaluate this integral here by using the antiderivative function big f of b minus big f of a. So very soon we'll have a bunch of integration or antiderivative formulas to use, but for right now, let's find our antiderivative using what we know about derivatives. We want to find a function big f of x such that its derivative is equal to the integrand function 2x. So we want a function that has a derivative of 2x. So thinking about the power rule for a moment, notice how if we had x squared, the derivative would be 2x. So we'll use the antiderivative function 2x to help us evaluate this def integral. We could use 2x plus a constant, but notice because of this subtraction, the constant would simplify out. So this will be equal to the antiderivative x squared when we evaluate it at the upper limit of integration of 3, and then the lower limit of integration of 1, and then find the difference. So when x is 3, or for big f of 3, we would have 3 squared minus, and then when x is 1, or for big f of 1, we'd have 1 squared. Well, this would be 9 minus 1, which is equal to 8. Now there is one more thing to mention here. The function f of x equals 2x is non-negative over the closed interval from 1 to 3, which means the value of this def integral would represent the area bounded by the function on the x-axis over this closed interval. So let's take a look. So because our def integral is equal to 8, where this is the graph of f of x equals 2x, if we consider the interval from 1 to 3, this interval here, the value of this def integral is equal to the area of the shaded region. If we wanted to verify this geometrically, we could use the area formula for a trapezoid, which we've done in previous examples. I hope you found this helpful.